Good evening in Tel Aviv.
Good evening, good evening. Good morning in LA.
I know. Look at your beautiful studio.
Yeah, thank you.
So we talked yesterday and you're not gonna be able to go back to the studio as of tonight, is that right?
Yeah, I've been in New York maybe a little bit over a couple of weeks ago, and then when I came back to Tel Aviv, I had to stay for 2 weeks in quarantine. I was able to come here today, and then tomorrow we're going I will not be able to come here again. We're going to be in lockdown.
Lockdown, yeah.
Lockdown. So that's my only day in my studio, so I really miss
it. Well, thank you for joining us. The whole purpose, everybody, the Thinking of Art series is really to join artists around the world and see how everybody's doing and give you an inside glimpse on artists that I know and that I really respect. So Rotem Reshef, she's a Tel Aviv and New York-based artist, abstract painter and installation artist, and you can see some incredible paintings behind her. We met Rotem how many years ago? 10 years ago?
Oh, yeah, probably, a long time ago. When I was still living in New York, it was a really, really long time ago.
Yeah, and when I was still living in New York.
Yeah.
Yeah. Those are amazing times. I remember the first time I met you, I fell in love with your process and you. You're such a warm, genuine, consistent person. And I think all the close friends that I have those characteristics of consistency and some aspect of passion in their life. And you definitely do. We've done some really fun projects together and had some great sales together. And we did the exhibition at Soho House together in West Hollywood, and right. The Spectrum installation, which you created specifically for Soho House with me, and that was a lot of fun. And so I just wanted to turn it over to you and talk about how did you become a painter, and is it something you always dreamed of doing?
I guess it was. I mean, I was painting and doing installations when I was a kid in my at my room at home at my parents' house. So yeah, it was. I was always an artist, and I was studying art after the army. You know, in Israel it's mandatory. I was doing the army, and then I was studying in art school near Tel Aviv. And by the time I graduated, I stopped painting. I really enjoyed studying, but then when I graduated, it was a little bit traumatic. I was showing in the Ramat Gan Museum that just opened in Israel. I got the America-Israel Cultural Foundation Scholarship, which was the only and best scholarship one could get, but then I stopped painting for 15 years. I got married, I have 4 kids, and about in 2001 we moved to the Netherlands with my family, and when we lived there I started to do my master's in museum studies. And while I was studying, burglars went into my parents' house in Israel, and what they stole was only 2 paintings of mine. And it was a life-changing moment. First, it was very, they were good burglars. I mean, it changed my life.
Right.
And my parents were heartbroken, and I decided to start painting again. And then I went to an art supply store in Amsterdam, and I bought materials. And the first time I came to visit Israel after that time, I came with 2 paintings. And that was 2003, and since then I haven't stopped painting.
Wow.
So that was major. The second major thing that I discovered when I started to paint again was the use of diluted paint. I'm using acrylic paint. I was always using water-based acrylic paint.
Mm-hmm.
But what was special, and I'm always using, as you can see behind me, very saturated colors, and I like to work on large scale. But what was special about the diluted paint was that there is a range or tension about how much I can control the paint and how much the paint is doing its own thing. And this is what drives my painting since 2003 until today.
Okay. So one of the...
I just But people, do you have a question, or shall I just keep on talking about
it? Yeah, no, I wanted to ask you about, I mean, your first museum exhibition was in the, was outside of New York in Westchester at the Katona Museum. And I think, I mean, I followed your career for what, 10, 15 years, you know, now, and from, it's been really inspiring to see how persistent you've been and how determined you've done from your public installations in Tel Aviv, which the, you know, the huge public installations you've done there, to private installations, and then in California you did a big installation. But talk about the most recent one at the Katona Art Museum, Arcadia.
Yeah, so exactly almost to the day, 2 months ago, I closed an exhibition at the Katona Art Museum, which showed for 3 months. It was a painting installation. It was made with two scrolls of canvas, one which I called the blue scroll, which was the 27 yards, and the other one, which I called the green scroll, which was something like 10 yards. They were both made with plants. Since 2014, I started to do a series I called imprints. In imprints, I imprint different materials on the in the wet paint on the canvas. And the first 2 years, I was using plastics and threads, and I was really excited about what I get from these humble materials. After about 2 years, because everything was so organic, I decided to use organic materials. And then I started to use plants. I don't cut or trim trees. I usually go on the streets or with my car to parks or to different places, and then I pick up plants that are already considered trash and something that nobody is going to use them. And I take them to my studio and I imprint them on the canvas. You can see behind me, it's a painting in process. So I put the plants on the canvas and I pour the paint and I let it sink and let it dry. And when it dry, I peel it off. So this is what I was doing in Arcadia. I was doing one large scroll with plants I picked up in New York, and the other green scroll I made with plants I picked up in the grounds of Katona Museum of Art, which is so beautiful there. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's gorgeous.
And the two canvases were very different, and they were complementing each other.
Right.
Yeah. So.
How long was that exhibition? That exhibition was up for how long?
It was on for 3 months.
Three months.
It showed next to a Sparkling Amazons, which was an exhibition following the women of abstract expressionism, and I was kind of as humble as I can say, I was representing the a contemporary female artist doing abstract art, expressionism. So,
well, congratulations on that. That was huge for you. Talk a little bit more about your. So, are you? You're only acrylic based, right? And are
Yes, I am. I paint with acrylic, and I usually paint on canvases. I always paint on the floor because I'm pouring the paint, and while I'm pouring it, I like the canvas to be on the floor and accept the paint. So if you look behind me, you can see I work on large scrolls of canvases, which I buy. It's 27 yards, so I just paint section by section. In Israel, in Tel Aviv, I have a larger studio, so I can open much larger portions of the canvas. In New York, where I have another studio, I can open, you know, so much as a New York studio can afford. And then I paint just section by section, just more sections, and then I still paint the same.
How often are you back and forth between Tel Aviv and New York? And now with the coronavirus, how long do you think you're going to be in Tel Aviv now?
Well, I don't know. Nobody knows, right? I mean,
yeah.
Depends. I mean, when Arcadia was on, I would go every month for something. I mean, the first month I was for a month in New York, then I went for a couple of weeks each month. Usually I try to say that I spend 2 weeks every 2 months, but it becomes more and more often. But now, I don't know, it's really, I mean, I'm we have other things to worry about besides me traveling to New York and having fun.
Of course, absolutely.
Museums, galleries, showing, meeting, clients.
Of course. But, yeah, how has it affected your, like, other artists that you know there in Tel Aviv right now? Like, what are other artists saying as far as, you know, not being able to access their studio. Are you going to be able to paint at home? Are you setting up a temporary space in your house right now?
I do have a home studio. I wasn't able to go there because I was in quarantine. I was in my bedroom for 2 weeks. So this is something I brought some canvases home and paint home, and I'll definitely paint. But I do want to understand what I want to do, because I think the world is really changing. It's a big opportunity. It's not only bad. I mean, good things are also happening.
I agree with you.
And it's really scary, and nobody knows what to do, and so many people are losing their jobs. But something, you know, I'm an optimistic person, so I really hope that something will come out of it. And I want to do the same with art. I want to understand exactly what I want to say, how I want to bring this horrible thing. Usually I paint from joy, let's say. I don't bring really horrible things to my canvases. And I want to do the same with the corona. So I need to really figure out how I'm bringing this new thing into my art. And it's a process. Thinking is part of the process. I mean, you know, meditating is part of the process. Gathering materials is part of the process.
So, absolutely. I know, yeah. I mean, for me, like being alone for the last, I don't know, 16, 17 days, you know, I think I came up with the idea of this series to, you know, try to reach out to people. And I think with everybody around the world, it's forcing them to not only go more and become more introspective, but just to tap on areas of creativity that they haven't, you know, had time to really focus on before. And I think that that's a beautiful process. So talk about kind of one of your favorite pieces that you created. Is there a piece behind you that you can... that maybe speak to, that everybody can see?
Yeah. I mean, if you look on the back, you can see the blue and green painting. It's a painting from a series of Habitat. Habitat was a series that in which I imprint people. Usually I'm an abstract painter, but in Habitat I use clothes to imprint people. On the back, this is me. Most of the paintings are very nature-oriented and very green, and this one has the blue around it. So the colors are a little bit different than usual. There is a figure, it's floating in the air or lying on the grass, and there is something about the connection between a person and the nature around it, which is really important to me, and this is what this series is all about. It's about habitat, it's about where we are, who we are, and the world that surrounds us and how we connect with it.
Oh, that's really relevant right now. I mean, I left New York mainly because I wanted to be around nature more, and I'm so happy that I'm here right now. And I, like, for anybody that's viewing, you can go to Rotem's site, you can go to kipton.com/thinkingofart to read about Rotem and see some of her work. What we're gonna do as a follow-up once we get through this is take everybody into her studio and do a virtual tour and actually walk around in the studio. So if you wanna schedule those private tours, let me know, and we'll, once Rotem gets back in the studio again, we'll do that. Yeah, we'll do that. So we're at 15 minutes in, and we're trying to keep these at 15 minutes to give sound bites to people, and everybody's busy on this Sunday morning on the West Coast, and in Europe it's in the evening. So Rotem, thank you so much. Thank you for your time. Be safe. Be safe, stay healthy. Love to you and your family, and I'll talk to you soon.
Yes, thank you.